As I promised, I will now tell you of Aphrodite's treachery and how Paris was nothing but a pawn in the eternal game played by the gods at the expense of men. Barely a year after Priam had brought his lost son Paris back into his household, the three goddesses, Hera, Athena, and Aphrodite, visited the young prince. They asked him to choose the fairest among them, a question mighty Zeus himself refused to answer, for he knew that preferring one meant making an enemy of the other two. So he convinced the goddesses to let Paris make the choice. The three goddesses bribed the young prince with fortune, conquest, and love. And gentle Paris chose love, chose passion, chose Aphrodite. Was it the rashness of youth that blinded the young Paris to make a choice Zeus himself dared not consider? Aphrodite made true her promise and brought Paris to the most beautiful woman on earth, Helen, wife of Menelaus. I have already told you what happened next, and the consequence thereof. Because of an act of reckless love, many were brought to pay a hefty price. Cassandra's prophecy was about to come true. But those who never believed what she foretold pointed to Hector, riding a wave of victory over the retreating Greeks. Hector easily breached the Grecian wall. On his side was Paris, shoulder to shoulder with the rest of the Trojans, not intent on glory, but yearning for redemption.
Paris! Paris, don't just stand there! Hector has breached the walls! We must attack!
You're right, brother. It's time to end this. For Troy!
At long last, light the way, torchbearer.
Of all our suffering.
Ah!
We'll be overwhelmed if we keep going.
Go back if you want, Defobo. I won't rest until we finish this.
We can stand alone against the Greeks, but not alone against the gods.
Phobos! No! I will not give up.
Ah!
Why do you meddle in our affairs? We might end the war, the suffering, today!
You care about others' suffering, but you do not think twice about causing it. You chose lust over sanity. You chose Aphrodite over me!
Thank you.
Deos must have known that he could not choose between you. That is why he passed the choice to me.
And you believe you can do what God could not? It was never your choice to make, Prince.
Thank you.
not think that you have saved yourself today, young prince. In the fabric of time, a few more days, weeks, are nothing but a drop in the ocean.
Zeos, you tricked me! I was doomed, whatever my choice. I am mocked by the gods, but I'll mock them back instead. Watch as I set the Greek ships on fire! Achilles, he is back. What next?
You are the torch which brings fire and death to Troy.
What next?